Catholic students protest hiring of popular gay teacher.
Firing? Firing of gay?
Yes.
Okay, good.
In Kettering, Ohio, English teacher Jim Zimmerman had taught English at Alter High School for 23 years. Then someone anonymously mailed a copy of his marriage certificate to the archdiocese showing that he was married to another man and his teaching skills were no longer wanted. The archdiocese and school did not disagree about Zimmerman's ability as an educator, but instead said that he violated his contract by being gay and marrying another man. In protest, dozens of Alter High School students gathered at a park next to the school where they displayed messages of support from their car windows and blasted a playlist of Zimmerman's favorite songs.
What the hell? How does it, was that in the contract? You do not get to say wow.
They have to sign like a morality. Teachers who work for the Archdiocese of Cincinnati, they have to sign annually a teacher minister contract that includes an agreement to refrain from conduct that is, quote, in contradiction to Catholic social doctrine or morals. And then they include some examples of behaviors that are included but not limited to cohabitation outside of marriage. So even if you were in a heterosexual relationship but you weren't married, you can't live together. Sexual activity out of wedlock and same-sex sexual activity. The contract also says that promoting such conduct is acceptable as a violation. So even if you're not doing it, but you say it's okay for people to do it, it's considered a violation.
By the way, just wanted to highlight, Tommy is saying, where's the fourth horseman? I think they're referring to Chopin. He's in the YouTube live chat. But okay, is that even legal?
Because it's not a public school.
No, like, could you actually have a legal contract in the United States? Where is this? This is United States.
Ohio. It's in Kettering, Ohio.
Can you have like a legal contract that tells you about your your sexual life, who you get to date, who you get to be with? Like, is that no, does that stand in court as a legal contract that's a condition?
Lots of private businesses or private things have morality clauses that people have to sign. And because it's not a public school.
Oh my gosh. Wait, I'm reading the contract right now. Teacher minister also agrees to exemplify Catholic principles in a manner consistent with teacher minister's relationship with the Catholic Church and to refrain from any conduct or lifestyle which would reflect discredit on or cause scandal to the school or be in contradiction to Catholic social doctrine or morals. While the school does not mean to suggest that teacher minister is involved in such conduct or lifestyle, by way of example, such conduct or lifestyle that is in contradiction to Catholic social doctrine, blah, 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 includes but is not limited to cohabitation outside of marriage, sexual activity outside of wedlock, same-sex sexual activity, use of abortion, use of a surrogate mother, use of I mean, it just goes on and on.
Mm-hmm.
You can't use artificial insemination, advocacy for such conduct.
Okay, so how come this is, but it would be illegal if they said that they're against race mixing, right? That would be illegal.
I don't know, because the thing with the United States and people's deeply held beliefs, you know.
We should cut that part out. That was beautiful. Okay. Right.
It's hard to say, you know. I think that probably there, you know, I mean, the Mormon Church didn't let black people become,
but that's illegal now.
They changed it. It wasn't because, you know, they were, you know,
and they changed it in the '70s, long after
1978 or whatever.
Because they were forced to. But again, so like I know in some states discrimination against gay people is illegal. Whatever, it doesn't matter if you're public or private. Okay, you cannot, like, for example. Nowhere in the United States can have a sign, even if you're a private company, you can't have a sign that says, we don't serve black people here, okay? You cannot do that. That's illegal in the United States. Private, public, it doesn't matter, right? So the problem is that in some states you can't, it's illegal to discriminate against gay people, and in some states it isn't. Is Ohio not one of those ones that is covered, like discrimination against gay
people? It's a lot of municipalities have, some municipalities have protections for LGBT people or benefits for same-sex marriages, and then some don't. Some have, and that area of Ohio, Cincinnati, or this is in Dayton, Cincinnati area, tends to be more conservative. Ohio also had an amendment stating that prior to same-sex marriage becoming legal, they had an amendment stating that marriage was only between a man and a woman. I think it was Amendment 11. So they had a pretty clear statement as, you know, a populace, because it passed, people voted for it, about how they felt about same-sex relationships.
Imagine if we had a school or any other organization that said, the contract said you can't be a Christian working here, right? It's against our moral code for you to be Christian, and you have to agree that you're not a Christian when you're signing this contract, and that you never, that if you ever consider Christianity, then you would be fired. Imagine the outrage on United States. Imagine the backlash to that by the Christians.
Oh, here it is. So I just was Googling it. The law of banning same-sex marriage that I was talking about, they eventually, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that it was unconstitutional eventually. But in Ohio, there's no specific law in the state of Ohio that prohibits employment discrimination based on a person's status as gay or lesbian. Some municipalities, like I said, do prohibit that, but as a whole, the state of Ohio does not.
Hmm. Okay. By the way, with regards to deeply held beliefs, there's a lot of laws in the United States based on whether you have deeply held beliefs or not. How do they test that? Aren't most Christians and Muslims and Jews, there's a lot of them that are, it's not very deeply held. They're like, you're a Muslim. Yeah. And what do you believe in? What do you pray? People are like, meh. So are those religious beliefs not deeply held? Is there a test? Is there a way for you to test if this is deeply held? I don't understand.
It seems to me if you say you have deeply held beliefs, then that's all you need to do. I mean, that's what it appears to be, because there's been so many cases where people, I don't want to serve this person because making them a cake violates my deeply held beliefs. I can't administer this medicine because it violates.
But that's code for religion without actually saying religion, but it's not consistent, because if you say my deeply held beliefs are that I don't like black people and I don't want to serve them, people are going to be like, no, go fuck yourself, you can't do that. But yet they consider religions deeply held beliefs, even though most religious people don't hold their beliefs very deeply, right? So they're trying to say religion without being against the Constitution, because you can't pass laws based on religion, and they're using the word deeply held belief, but they're not being consistent in what's deeply held belief.
And also, it also depends on what your deeply held belief code religion is, because the Church of Satanic Temple, rather, they sued the state of Missouri about their anti-abortion laws because they said those laws violated their deeply held beliefs.
Hmm.
Well, they couldn't win that lawsuit. So their deeply held beliefs are not considered valid, but other people's deeply held beliefs are valid.
Hmm. Clark on Facebook is saying Susanna's cute and a heart symbol.
Thank you.
No, Susanna, you're supposed to get offended. You're supposed to say, how dare you judge my looks, instead of, this is sexism, I'm outraged. Ban him, Armin. You have to do that.
That should be illegal.
Actually, I'm the one who's really upset that no one said I'm cute.
I think I said you were pretty before it started. I said you look pretty today.
I'm just kidding. I mean, the public.
Mm. Oh, okay. More people type how cute Rivka is today. Come on, guys. Okay, there's Smitty saying Rivka is cute. There you go. Okay. All right.
You're making me blush.
News. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And like, oh, they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But people are like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. They're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah, subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos, because you know, we do get demonetized, that's an obvious, on every one of our videos, so F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized, what does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right, and all that, you know, on people's homepages, and that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow, so we need you guys to share our videos.